Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. It's a full house. Very cool to see. Before we get started, thought I would tell you about another opportunity that your students might be interested in, if they're interested in singing, which is the musical this year, which is Space Pirates. They're going to start rehearsal next week. It will be Tuesday and Wednesday mornings, and then the performance will be the first weekend of March. So if you're interested in that, there's some forms on the back table. Just another opportunity to get your kids performing. What we're doing tonight, though, is the second and third graders concert, American Patchwork. They worked very hard. They had a really nice performance this morning, so we hope that you enjoy. Thank you again for coming. We are on native land. Simply put, all land is native land. Various indigenous people inhabited the area of North America and beyond long before it was discovered by Europeans. When Christopher Columbus landed in the Americas, there were 50 million indigenous people living on the continent. Currently, there are 574 federally recognized Native American tribes within the continental U.S. and Alaska, each with its own unique culture, language, and way of life. Over 9 million Native Americans and Native Alaskans live in the U.S. today.
Thank you.
next song is a traditional dancing song from the Shakers. The Shakers were a Protestant group that began in England and migrated to the U.S. They practiced communal living, where all property was shared. Communities were agriculturally based, and men and women lived and mostly worked apart. Like the Quakers, the Shakers were pacifists who had advanced notions of gender and racial equality. Simplicity in dress, speech, and manner were encouraged, as was living in rural colonies. They dedicated their lives to creating a heaven on earth. Slavery is an ugly part of American history, but must be recognized as a piece of our collective tapestry. Taken at face value, a drinking gourd refers to the hollowed-out gourd used by slaves and other rural Americans as a water dipper. But here it is used as a code name for the Big Dipper constellation, which points to Polaris, the Pole Star, and North. The drinking gourd song was supposedly used by an Underground Railroad operative to encode escape instructions and a map. These directions then enabled fleeing slaves to make their way north from Mobile, Alabama to the Ohio River and freedom.
When the sun comes up and the first girl calls,
Donegal, Ireland, after being caught in a vicious storm. It is believed that the experience led to him writing the song Amazing Grace, and later denouncing his involvement in the slave trade and slavery itself. After crossing the Atlantic, the song was taken up by American Christian preachers and later became a well-known anthem of the civil rights movement. The lyrics represent a personal journey many people can relate to, wanting to find meaning in our lives through faith. It offers hope to those who are wishing to become better and positively change their life around, yet it does not appear judgmental. It is a song that has transcended any one meaning, but its universal message stays the same. You may know our nation's railroads were built largely by African Americans and immigrants. It was grueling work, and it was no doubt made more tolerable by the presence of music. It helped lift the workers' spirits in a similar fashion to the field calls and folk songs developed out of the slave tradition. In the case of I've Been Working on the Railroad, the telling line is, all the live long day. These men really did backbreaking work that lasted well beyond the hours of labor now acceptable in our society.
Can't you hear the whistle blow?
Following the Civil War, railroads began to spread across the country, and some immigrants found seasonal work as cowboys. Each spring, these cowboys would drive herds of cattle to the railheads where they would be shipped and sold. Around the campfire at night, and sometimes on the job, they sang and wrote songs to tell of their lives and work. Our next song originated as a poem and has become the unofficial anthem of the American West. Woody Guthrie grew up in small town Oklahoma, but it didn't take long for him to hit the road. He walked, hitched rides, and rode the rails all over the country, first going to the Gulf Coast, then west to California. It was the Great Depression, and Guthrie shared the road with former farmers, laid-off factory workers, and migrants chasing hopes of work. Along the way, he chronicled their adventures, dreams, and sorrows in song. What he saw and experienced as he crisscrossed the country contributed to his emergence as a social commentator.
Thank you.
That's all we have for you. Thanks once again for being here. You're welcome to grab your students and be on your way. Have a good night.